Greetings, beloved co-creators, family of light. I am that I am, Gilles Mancio, and I come to you today briefly to discuss, offer some thoughts on ascension. And of course, this is only to do for maybe only of interest to those who are interested in such a process. Not everyone has such interest at this time, although Neptune and Chiron are working together to really expand the mind of humanity right now, and I think there is a great possibility of a massive healing and an universal awareness that may be created by all the conjunction in the solar system. And so today is a quantum day. It is February 29. It is a day out of time. It teaches us how to that there is a the quantum state is really the state of possibility. It is something non-linear. The lesson in that is that if you can dream it, it is possible. Of course, not all dreams can come into being right away. But even if during your sleep you have dreams, know that it is something that that is being played out. Doesn't mean that if you have a nightmare, you're going to be experiencing anything like that. It may be just a release of energy that you need to release. So you go on the astral plane to release those things. But there are a very powerful dreams sometimes that are informing you of the future, what is before you. And so also when you become you open your third eye, you begin to receive a vision, and so those visions are usually informing you of the direction of your life. They may not all make sense, but they do in time for your soul. Your spirit already know where you're going. Not all the details are being worked out in advance, but the general line of our life is already been written by us before we even came down to this world, before we incarnated. And so originally the design for the spiritual education that was given to primitive people on this planet was, in terms of calendar, was a 13 months year, because there's 13 moon every year, and there is 4 weeks within each of those 28 days, with 4 weeks within each month. And so starting of a new moon, there is a new month, and so that made a lot of sense. He was creating harmony. But at some point in the evolution of the planet, the control of those things became fall into some kind of there was a dark scenario that was investigated and expanded, and this in order to create fear and confusion, we ended up with this very bizarre kind of calendar. However, we adapted. And so now we're learning to live in the now. We are awakening to the truth of ourselves. And the more we are able to connect in the now, the more we are able to connect to other dimension. And so through our consciousness, for consciousness is really what it is all about. Consciousness is in evolution, it is in expansion, but it is also becoming something else, something more. And it is all going through. It is going through the circle and cycle of eternity. So there is no, there is never ending to evolution. We all come to realize that once we achieve a higher level of consciousness. But no matter what, whatever we don't achieve in this lifetime, we will be able to achieve it later on. For we are eternal beings. Of course, all those things I'm talking about is my own thoughts, my own understanding, my own knowledge. It is not my belief. It is more than belief. For me, it is those are actual the eternal truths. We can never change an eternal truth. It is they are eternal, so they cannot be changed. However, we can believe anything else in the meantime. When I said we have to listen to the inner voice, I wanted to also to clarify that. I was talking about the voice within the heart, the voice of reason, the voice of wisdom, because there are many voices that are expressing themselves within the mortal mind. And so some people also have created alter ego within their mind. It's a voice that is constantly in the critical state, that is always needs to be better than others, pointing to all the mistakes, pointing to all the problems, the deficiencies. Sometimes this voice is loud and it can be overwhelming, but it has to be turned off, and slowly we have to make breathing exercise to find a way to calm ourselves. in order to be more calm and to listen to the voice of the heart that is always with a loving attitude and always have a great deal of wisdom to share. So we have to silence the busyness of our mind in order to hear that. But once we listen to that, there is a call, and the call is for to return to the source of all that is. Of course, we have to learn to disconnect sometimes to the pressure of the world, the 3D pressure. It's not because you go into meditation and you let go of everything that you won't be back to deal with those situations in 3D. For if you are a human being, you will be called back to that. But it's the ability to disconnect completely from the temporal illusion of the world, so that you may resource yourself, get some light from your soul, and then when you return into this world to re-deal with all those problems of 3D, you have a greater perspective for your consciousness as evolved through the process of your meditation. Those things may come sooner or later, so it's not do not be discouraged if you are not achieving anything. It's usually in meditation, it's usually when we stop having expectation that things begin to happen. When it comes to opening your third eye, I've already said that, but I recommend to eliminate fluoride from your diet, from your toothpaste. Find a toothpaste that does not have fluoride, for it calcifies the pineal gland. And so every day we receive thousands and thousands of thoughts. So the thoughts, we're not as thoughts. We are not that. We are not even responsible for our thoughts, but we are responsible for the emotion we attach to the thoughts. For we create those emotions in relationship to thoughts. Those emotions can be positive, negative, or neutral. And they can be fearful, loving, or detached. So it's good to keep a little distance in relationship to certain thoughts that may be pushing buttons within ourselves. Of course, it is easier said than done, but because sometimes certain thoughts can make us sad, make us angry, make us confused. But if we can keep a certain emotional detachment, neutrality, we'll see that the situation can evolve much more rapidly than if we entangle ourselves within a process of energy that creates this sadness, this anger, this confusion. So if we let go of outcome, things get easier. So in a sense, you want to be able to choose to respond to thoughts, to put your emotion into thoughts that create joy, that create peace, that create happiness within you. And all your loving thoughts towards others, towards yourself, are deeply appreciated, because everything builds. Every day we build a new layer to our life, just like in hypnosis. We compound this experience. Some days are easier, some days are harder. We do not judge ourselves from the difficulty we have or the struggle we have. We just go through it and we learn from that experience. And finally, I wanted to speak of gratification and pleasure. It's something that I really care about: pleasure, enjoyment. But there is a big difference between instant gratification and delayed gratification. Instant gratification is usually something that children are seeking, and as adults we are learning to experience a delayed gratification. But then now, with the computer age, we click on a button, we have exactly what we want right away, or with drugs, or say we seek instant gratification, or alcohol, cigarette. We're looking for things that can numb our pain, and so those things have to be understood, that there has to be a certain, if you can breathe a few times when you have this need to feel a void within you, if you can take a few breaths to think about it, then usually the energy has changed and you can change your mind. For in terms of addiction begins when the choice becomes unconscious, when you're doing something that you do not want to do. But being aware of that, you can also change it by unconditional love towards yourself, and therefore following the ways of wisdom. In terms of delayed gratification, ascension is the ultimate reward, the ultimate gratification that will be fulfilled at the end of the program. For all souls will eventually reach this ascension potential, this ascension state of being. And so you have to be balanced within you cannot be too strict in relationship to your ego, to your senses. They have habits that may not all be good for you, but you still want to be able to fulfill them. You can't be too hard on them, but you want to make sure that you keep moving in the progressive in a way that is progressive towards your ability to become natural, to become simple, to find how much joy can you find in simple pleasure, in just hearing the bird, watching a rainbow, sunset, just breathing in and out. How much joy can you get within that? How much fulfillment can you get within that? And so to learn to once we accept the more we accept to make that to move into that state of being, to move into that state of gratitude for our experience, no matter what it is, the more life can fill us with new energy, and we can move out of the old cycle, for that is really what is happening right now. And so so I hope this message was interesting for you. I wanted also to express my gratitude for listening to my message, for sharing, for commenting, if you have any comment. And I hope this day out of time will be positive. It is a day to express yourself, to be in your truth, and to keep that energy, so that you may be entering into the spring with that enthusiasm, that passion, that can be conducive to your ability to live a fulfilled life. I wish you a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.